As you mentioned previously, Rayo also spoke a lot about, well, encrypted communications. So maybe can you elaborate a bit on why this is so important in the Vonu strategy?
Yeah. So, you know, I say a lot that, you know, if the coercers can't find you, they can't coerce you. Well, the coercers can't read what you write, then they can't use, you know, they can't use your words against you. If all it is just, you know, illegible, you know, ciphertext, then, yeah, they can't really get a whole lot out of that. So yeah, encrypted communication certainly plays a role in the Vonu sphere. And, a further iteration, I would say, you know, we've got, Rayo talked about kind of the encrypted ham radio networks. There's obviously the low tech, ciphers, using, pen and paper. A newer kind of iteration that I'll toss in that's Kyle Reardon actually wrote an article on. It's in his book, Just Below the Surface, Guide to Security Culture, but that's called dual layer encryption. And the idea is that, digital encryption is great, but why not add an extra layer of security to it? So the idea is to come up with a handwritten cipher. And you would put that into PGP. You'd write the message, you'd encrypt it with the handwritten cipher, whatever you and the recipient agree upon. You would put that into, say, PGP or whatever encryption software you're using. It would encrypt it there, then they would decrypt it on their end digitally, then they would decrypt it manually on the other end. So yeah, I mean, all this stuff, plays into it. If you look into Rayo's writings, he was, back in the 1960s, there are some things like, I mean, he went about as far as you could, in this realm of privacy and security culture. So, it plays a major role. Again, if the coercers can't find you, they can't coerce you. And if they can't read what you write, then they can't use your words against you.